Okay guys, so the first tip is to always use colors from different undertones. So as you guys can see right here in the palette, I have four colors from orange undertone and four colors from pink undertone. Now I talk about it a lot. So basically your skin doesn't have only one undertone. Your skin has colors from different undertones. That is why it is advised to at least incorporate colors from two different undertones. So as you guys can see right here on the base that I have right here on the screen has this really brownish or bronzy looking shade on the face, and this is from obviously orange undertone. And then I went ahead and created shadows with some of the colors with pink undertone, and then I went ahead, I built the color up, and as you guys can see it's like a combination of a color with orange undertone and color with pink undertones. Okay guys, so the next tip is to always start with a base color. As you guys can see, I am in the layer 6 and I actually shaded the face in this particular layer where I added the solid base color on the face, and you have to do that too. You can't just go ahead and just add shadows like this on the face without having a solid base color on the face. Now it's just gonna look crazy, and if your background color, if you're gonna change your background color, let's just say red or something else, the face is just gonna look see-through in a sense, and that is why it is always advised to use a solid base color and then start with the shading part of it. Okay guys, so the next tip is to slowly build the colors, especially if you're using colors from different undertones. Then you should make sure always to create different layer for different colors. So as you guys can see on this base layer, layer number 6, I actually have this one shade. I'm using just one color to create shadows, and then I just went ahead and created more shadows with a different color, and then I created even more shadows using a different color. So basically what I'm trying to say is try to build colors layer by layer. So let's just suppose in one layer you have a color, or you have shadows with a color with orange undertone, and in the next layer you have shadows with the color with a pink undertone. I hope that is making sense. Okay guys, so the next tip is don't apply blush only on the cheek. So as you guys can see, layer number 10 is where I actually added blush on the face, but it was not just the face. As you guys can see, if I hide it, the blush is on the neck, on the cheeks, a little bit on the bridge of the nose, and a little bit of it is on the forehead as well. So that's what I do with the blush. I don't just add it on the cheeks. It just looks weird. So just incorporate that pink color, that color for blush, incorporate that on forehead as well. A little bit of it on forehead, a little bit of it on the neck. So just to balance everything out. So that's what I personally do. Okay guys, so the next tip is to keep a combination of soft and harsh looking details. Now what do I mean by that is keep a combination of some harsh looking shadows or highlights like these, or maybe like this, or on the crease area. As you guys can see, these shadows or these highlights are not completely blended. There is a little bit of harshness with them, which is necessary, and some of them are really nicely blended. As you guys can see, over the cheeks, the bronzer or that shadow is nicely blended with the face. You cannot really see those harsh edges of that color because it is nicely blending with the skin. So that is really important to keep good balance of these shadows. As you guys can see right here as well, I have a little bit of harshness around here, and that is necessary. So just keep a good balance of harsh looking shadows and harsh looking highlights, and some soft looking shadows and soft looking highlight. Okay guys, so the next tip is to add colors from the environment on the face or on the neck. So as you guys can see right here on this painting, on the layer number 18, I have this bluish kind of color on the face as well as on the neck. Let me just show you if you're not able to see it. Here is the blue color right here. A little bit of it is right here and on the forehead as well. So the reason why you do this is because our skin actually reflects back the light around us or the environment we are in. So what I did is I just picked up a color from the background and I added that color on the face, on the neck, so that the character doesn't look separate from the background. That is one tip that I always use. Now the next tip is quite similar to it as well. So the next tip is to add lighting on the face to give it some dimensions. So as you guys can see right here, a line of this really bright color, that is basically me adding some light, as if some light is hitting his face from behind. I actually added the color on the neck as well. Some of it I added on the hair, like right here, on his clothes as well, right here as well. As you guys can see, it's a little bit of the color, a little bit of the bright light color on the face and on his clothes, but it actually makes the whole painting look much more realistic if you are going for that look, or much more dimensional. And I did the same with all of my paintings, as you guys can see. So the last tip is to slowly build the highlights. So as you guys can see in layer number 9 and layer number 10, I have highlights. So what I basically do is, in the first layer, I keep the highlights nicely blended. Now they are not completely blended or completely blending out with the skin. A little bit of harshness is there, but it is still blended as compared to the layer where I added really harsh looking highlights. So I build these up slowly, and when I combine both of these layers, the highlights look so good on the face and so realistic. That's how I actually add highlights, and I actually divide the highlights in two separate layers. Now in this painting as well, I have two layers for highlights. One is really nice and really soft, really nicely blended, and the other is a little bit too harsh as compared to the previous one. And when I combine both of these layers, the highlights actually look really, really good. So yeah, I'm not gonna go into detail how I shade, how I blend, because I already have tutorials on those topics, and I'll give all the links down in the description. Other than that, I really hope you guys enjoyed today's tutorial, and if you did, please do not forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Also subscribe to my channel, I post every Monday and Friday, and also do follow me on Instagram, and I will see you guys the next time.